We all know life is short, and that's true, too, for man's best friend, and dog owners cherish the years that they have with their pets.
One local woman decided to take that a step further, creating a doggy bucket list. Channel 4's Heather Lee has the story of Chase and a long and emotional goodbye.
Energy is not something this dog lacks. And don't let that face full of gray fool you.
He loves to chase the ball. That's how he got his name. He will play fetch with you until your arm falls off. He will not stop.
Are you ready?
She's not kidding. Which is why what she's about to tell you is so difficult.
About a month ago, he was diagnosed with lymphoma, which is a cancer. He's got maybe a month or two left with us.
That doesn't seem like a lot of time.
No, but it's never really long enough.
How do you thank a dog that has given you unconditional love for more than a decade?
Go to the beach. He really loved the feel of the sand under his paws. Have breakfast in bed with Dad.
That's right. She's come up with Chase's bucket list.
Can't have steak without mashed potatoes.
Bucket list. Steak dinner, first time.
I hate the disease, but I'm glad that I know, and I'm glad that I have this time to prepare myself and to make the most of our time together.
Come on.
Bucket list. Paint a masterpiece. And if you're wondering,
I'll sell it to you.
She's kidding. She's keeping this one. Yeah.
I feel like he's just like a part of me. He's an extension of myself. He's a dog, but he's very much a part of the family.
What do you think?
I love it. So what's life going to be like without him?
Oh, gosh. I try not to think about it too much because it hurts a lot.
That's probably because this isn't the first go-round for Ash. Her dog Buster was diagnosed with the same disease a few years ago. They tried to treat him, but it only extended his life by about 2 months.
I think the last thing on the list was...
I can't say it.
I know it's hard. Take your time.
The last thing on Chase's bucket list is to say goodbye, knowing that he loved unconditionally and gave back to us. And
I know you're not looking forward to that.
No, definitely not. But it is the kindest thing that I could ever do for him, is to say goodbye.
Goodbyes are hard.
Ugh, you're gonna make me cry.
Especially when they're forever.
Unfortunately, that goodbye happened yesterday. Chase lost his battle to cancer. You know, we were talking about this earlier. We both have had dogs. I have a dog. 8 years ago, we got our dog. It was my first ever. I can't even imagine. If we were to lose that dog, our whole house would fall apart. So I can't even imagine what she feels like. You have lost a dog.
You know, and I don't talk about it very often, Joy. It was many, many years ago. I had an old English sheepdog, Morris McGurk of River Mist, and he died. And I've never wanted another dog since then. My heart goes out to Christy Ash, and we're so grateful to her for sharing her story with us about Chase. But it's a hole in your heart that I don't believe ever heals. If you're a pet lover and you have a dog or a cat and you lose them, I just think you never forget it.
I agree. And, you know, unfortunately, Chase was not able to complete all those items on his bucket list, eat an ice cream cone or ride with the top down. But there is one final bucket list item that you can help him accomplish in his memory.
Raise money for shelter dogs. The goal is just $500. We have all the information on how you can do that inside this story, which you'll find on news4jax.com.